Hello everyone, welcome back to the Crafty Bee channel. Thank you for being here. So today we are going to be recreating the wrap skirt and the top with the bell or trumpet sleeves you see on the screen, and it's very simple and easy to make. So if this is what you like to learn, please stay tuned to the end of the video and learn. So I'm using this fabric here. You need like a drape fabric or sateen, crepe, all this fabric you can use for this style. But I don't really like this fabric I cut, but because of this tutorial, I just have to do it to show you how to cut and sew the wrap skirt and the top. It's just like how you sew this African Nigerian style called Iro and Buba. But with this wrap skirt, it's easier to tie it than tying the wrapper itself. So let's go straight into the video. To make the wrap skirt, you need your hip measurement times 2.5. So I've already cut out the fabric. This is the good side and this is the wrong side. And I cut 2 times my hip circumference plus half of my hip circumference. Hope you understand. For example, I'm using 42 inches for the hips. So you cut your fabric 42 times 2 plus half of this 42. So it will be 84 plus the half of your hip measurement, which is 21. So in all is 105 inches. That's the width of the fabric. The width of the fabric should be your hip circumference times 2.5. Or you can use 2.5 meters of fabric. And the length of the wrap is 50 inches. So the next thing to do is to cut the band. That's the belt for each side to tie. I want the belt a bit wider. I'm cutting on the good side so that you can see clearly. As when you are sewing your own, please cut it on the wrong side of the fabric. So this is it. So I want the belt to be 3 inches unfold. So I cut out 7 inches. Half inch is going to be the stitching allowance. The belt, I don't want it too long. So I'll cut about 28 inches. So these are 2 belts. I'm cutting 2 belts together. Let me divide it for you to see. So these are the 2 belts folded in half. So what I'm going to do now is to fold it on the wrong side, like so. I'm going to close this end and then stitch along the edges here up to this end, and then leave this side, one side open, to turn it inside out. I'm going to do it to these 2 pieces. Then for the wrapper, you are going to hem the edges as you used to hem your wrapper. So I'm going to hem all the 4 corners. I will take to my machine and hem all the 4 corners with 1 inch. That's for the wrapper. And I will sew the belt, turn it inside out, iron it, and then come and show you how to attach it to the wrap skirt. So the next thing is to cut the top. The skirt is very simple and the top is also very simple. So I've cut down the fabric because the fabric is difficult to handle. So this is the top. I folded it into 4, as you can see. 1, 2, 3, 4. I folded it on the wrong side and I folded it with my hip divided by 4, that's 3 inches. So now we are going to take the vertical measurements. Before then, I'm going to mark a line on top to serve as our starting line and our shoulder line. I folded the front and the back together because they are all going to have the same neckline. So we are going to start taking the vertical measurement from the shoulder to the bust point is 11.5 inches. I'm going to take 11 and a half inches across to get a straight line. And then from the shoulder to the waist is 17 inches. And I'm going to take that 17 inches across and draw a straight line. Next, I'm going to mark from the shoulder to the hip point is 26 inches. So from the shoulder to the length is 29 inches together with the hemming allowance. Because I want the top a bit longer. So I'm going to trim the edge straight. Next is to divide our shoulder by two. So dividing the shoulder by two is 8 inches. But because this is going to be a free top, I will mark 9 inches because I want the sleeve to fall a bit. Then on this 9 inches point, I come down 1 inch for the shoulder slope. So for the neck width, I'm taking 4 inches because it's not that deep. 4 inches by 3.5 inches. And I'm going to draw a careful line, create the neck, then I'll connect my shoulder slope from the 1 inch point to the neckline. So from this shoulder slope, I'll be marking that 9 inches for the armhole depth, 9 inches. So I'll measure what I have here for the half of the shoulder measurement and I'll mark it here. And I'll be extending the armhole line outward like this. So now is to create the armhole curve. To create the armhole curve, you need to impute your bust measurement. And the bust I'm using is 41 inches divided by 4 is 10.25. So on the chest line here, I'll mark 10.25. And I'm adding 3 inches, 2 inches for ease, and then 1 inch for the sewing allowance. Next is to create the armhole curve. To do that, you measure the line here, your armhole depth line, and find the midpoint, which is 4.5. And then you come in 1/2 inch, like so. Then you create your armhole curve. So on the waist line, I'm going to be dividing the waist measurement by 4, and then add 3 inches, 2 inches for ease, and then 1 inch for the sewing allowance. So the waist is 38 divided by 4 is 9.5, and then 3 inches for ease and sewing allowance. So on the hip line, the hip is 42 inches divided by 4 is 10.5 plus 3 inches. So I'm going to connect the points. Because this is a free top, if you have a big belly, you can connect straight from the bust measurement here straight down to the hemline. You just connect it straight without having this shape. So this is the top and it's easy to cut. You cut the front and the back together. So on the shoulder line, I'm adding 1/2 inch for the joining allowance. So this is it. It's just simple. So before you cut the sleeves, you measure around the armhole here and then you minus 1 inch from it because 1 inch is for the sewing allowance. So now I'm going to cut it out and then we cut out the bell sleeves. So this is it. Our front and the back is together. So the next thing to do now is to cut the bell sleeves. So I cut down the fabric and folded it into 4. That's for the 2 sleeves. So what I'll do now is to take the length of the sleeve first. I'm going to take 27 inches for the length of the sleeve, which is going to be for the joining of the shoulder to the top and then the hemming of the down. So I'm marking 27 inches across. So I'm going to cut it out. You take your cap height, which I'm using 5 inches for the cap height, and draw a line. So on this cap height line, I'm going to impute 1/2 of the armhole measurement, which is going to be 10. So around the arm is 20 because it's going to be free. And then I'm adding 1.5 inch for the sewing allowance. So next I'll be connecting it. Hope you know how to cut basic sleeves. I have the video for this basic sleeve on my channel, so I'll be linking it down. And then you find the midpoint, which is 5.5. And then you come here, find the midpoint of this, go to this side, find the midpoint of this. So on this down part, you go down 1/2 inch, and then you leave the middle mark and come on the up here, you go 1/2 inch. And I will be using my free hand, then you connect from the sleeve end here, connect to this 1/2 inch, you come down here. So it's very simple. And then on the down part, you determine how wide you want the trumpet sleeves to be. So in this case, I'm making mine 13 inches together with the side seam allowance. So from here now, I'm going to connect straight down with my ruler. Then cut it out. So our sleeve is ready. So I'm notching where I'll place on the shoulder point. So this is it, I notch it. So this is our sleeve. The next thing to do is to start joining them. You take the sleeves, you join it on the side with 1 inch all the way down to the hemline. And then you do the same to the second sleeve. And then for the top, we are going to cut a bias with the fabric to lock the edges. But before doing that, I'll start with the shoulder. I'll join the shoulder with 1/2 inch. Then I'll go to the side and use 1 inch to join it all the way to the hemline. Also join this side with 1 inch all the way to the hemline. Then I will use the bias to conceal all the edges of the neck. Then I'll come and show you how to attach the sleeves. So guys, I'm done joining all the pieces. This is the top. You see how beautiful the top look. I cut the same fabric bias to hem the neckline. So you see? And I went ahead and hemmed the down part of the top. So this is it. The front and the back neckline are the same. It's just a free top. And also, I'm done joining the sleeves. This is it. And I also hemmed the down part of the sleeves, as you can see. So what is left now is to take the sleeve and attach it to the top, like so. I will attach the sleeves to the top. And also, these are the beds for the wrapper. And as you can see, I left the opening here where I turned the bed inside out from. And I also went ahead and finished all the four edges of the wrapper. I told you it's very simple. Wrap skirt. We have different types of wrap skirt. I have another wrap skirt on my channel. I'll be linking it down for you to go and watch. And that wrap skirt is a different style altogether. It's a different way of making it. It's very stylish. And it has a top with a cow neck and also a balloon sleeve. It's very beautiful. I'll be linking it down for you to go and watch. So what I'll do next is the upper part of the wrapper, I'm going to attach the belt so that it's easy to tie around. So this is it. So this opening part, I'm going to place it on it this way. And then you fold it to be aligned with the hem, the 1 inch hem line, as you can see. Then I'll pin it and then I will take it to my machine and stitch it on the good side like this. I'll top stitch it like this and this way. And I'll do the same to the other edge of the wrapper. Then I'll come back and show you the finishing look. So guys, if you never subscribed to this channel yet, please do so by hitting on the subscribe button and also turn on your bell notification to be the first to be notified whenever I upload a new video. Share my videos, comment down the comment section below. I'm ever ready to answer your questions. Thank you for watching. See you in my next video. Bye. I love you. Bye.